Babe, I see you tossing and turning. Can you not sleep? Do you want me to get you some water? What should I do then? I really want to help you sleep. Read to you. Well, if you think it could help, I'll read you to sleep. I have this book filled with short stories. About that. All right then. Let me just find one. So the cool thing about this book is it's filled with short stories, but it also has a main story. This kind of makes me feel like I'm a teacher or something, you know? Okay, this story is called The Story of the Old Man of the Moon. Once there was a king who was quite powerful and proud. He was so proud that he demanded constant respect from his people. Whenever he made a trip out of the city, no matter what time of day or night, people were to leave their homes, get on their knees, and make deep bows as he passed, or else face the brutal punishment of his soldiers. The king was fierce in his anger as well as his pride. It is said he even expected the monkeys to come down from the trees to bow to him. The king was harsh with his subordinates, ruthless to his enemies, and pitiless to his people. All feared his wrath, and when he roared his orders, the people trembled. Behind his back, they called him King Tiger. King Tiger's most coveted wish was to be one of royal blood. His every decision was crafted for that purpose. Every manipulation was part of a strategy to achieve acceptance into the imperial family. As soon as his son was born, he began to make trips and to gain influence in hopes that his son could marry a member of the imperial family. One night, as the king traveled through the mountains again on a trip to gain favor for his son's future marriage, he saw an old man sitting alone in the moonlight. The old man ignored the passing horses and carriages, the silk brocade and the government seal, and simply continued reading a large book in his lap. Fingering a bag of red string beside him, the old man's indifference infuriated King Tiger, and he ordered the carriage to stop. However, even the halting noises did not make the old man look up. Finally, King Tiger exit his carriage and went to the old man, who was still engrossed in his book. "Do you not bow to your king?" he roared. The old man continued to read. "What are you reading that is so important?" the king demanded, and looked at the pages of the book. It was filled with scribbles and scrawls that were not of any language the king knew of. "Why, it's just nonsense written in here." "Nonsense," the old man said, finally looking up. "You fool, this is the Book of Fortune. It holds all the knowledge of the world, the past, present, and future." The king looked up again at the marks on the page. "I cannot read it," he said. "Of course not," the man said. "But I, the old man of the moon, guardian of the Book of Fortune, can read it. And with it, I can answer any question in the world." "You can answer any question in the world?" the king scoffed. "Very well. "Who will my son marry when he is of age?" The old man of the moon flipped the pages of the book. He said to himself. "Yes, here it is. Your son's future wife is now the 2-year-old daughter of the grocer in the next village." "The daughter of a grocer?" the king spat. "Yes," the old man of the moon continued. "Right. Right now she is wrapped in a blue blanket covered in white rabbits, sitting on the lap of her blind grandmother in front of her house." "No," the king said, "I won't allow it." "It's true," the old man said. "They were destined to be husband and wife. I myself tied the red cord that binds them." "What red cord?" King Tiger demanded. "Do you know nothing? I tie together everyone who meets with these red threads." The old man sighed when his bag full of red string. "When you were born, I tied your ankle to your wife's ankle with a red thread. And as you both grew older, the line became shorter until you eventually met. All the people you've met in your life have been brought to you by the red cords. I must have forgotten to tie an end of the lines, which is why you are meeting me now. I won't do that again." "I don't believe you," the king said. "Believe or don't believe," the old man said, standing up, putting the book on his back. "We have reached the end of our thread, and I will now leave." The king stared, dumbfounded, in silence, as the old man of the moon walked away up the mountain. "Crazy old man," the king said finally. "What a waste of my time." The king returned to his carriage and continued on. But as they drove through the next village, he saw an old blind woman holding a baby girl in front of a house. The girl was wrapped in a blue blanket covered with white rabbits, just as the old man of the moon had said. King Tiger burned with anger. "I will not let my son marry a grocer's daughter," he vowed. So after he arrived at the guest house, the king secretly ordered one of his servants to return to the grocer's home and stab the girl with a knife. "That will take care of her," he thought to himself. Many years later, King Tiger had his dream fulfilled. He was finally able to obtain a match for his son with one of the Imperial's many granddaughters, and his son would inherit the rule of a remote city. On the wedding day, King Tiger bragged to his son about how he had arranged the marriage and outwitted the old man of the moon. The son, who was not like his father, said nothing, but after the wedding ceremony, sent a trusted servant to find the grocer's family to make amends. In the meantime, he became acquainted with his bride and was happy to find that both were pleased with each other. He found his new wife beautiful. The only odd thing about her was this delicate flower on her forehead. "Dear wife," he said, "why do you always wear that flower? Even to sleep, you never remove it." "It is to hide my scar," she said, touching her forehead in embarrassment. "When I was a child, no older than 2, a strange man stabbed me with a knife. I survived, but I still have the scar." At that moment, the trusted servant came rushing in. "Master," he said, "I made the inquiries you asked for. In a flood many years ago, the grocer's family perished, except for the daughter. The king of the city, the emperor's ninth son, then adopted the daughter and raised her as his own, and that daughter is your wife." I really like that story.